customized fist that can be attached to male mannequins has been introduced here.
Currently, mannequins that are being used to teach CPR are in the male physique, but with this attachable fist, trained lifesavers can learn the proper techniques when performing CPR on the female anatomy.
Sometimes the rescuer will try to avoid the breast and put the hand in a slightly lower position. This will result in the actually wrong position and may cause more damage. So with a proper female mannequin, then at least they are used to the proper position.
The Singapore Heart Foundation hopes that the new training can also prevent people from delaying help. In a survey of 1,000 people, 6% said they would not want to perform CPR on a stranger because they were afraid of being accused of molest. But with each minute that nothing is done, chances of survival drop by almost 10%. Getting people trained to administer CPR properly is key, as the number of out-of-hospital cardiac arrests increases over the years. The Health Ministry's Unit for Pre-Hospital Emergency Care says it's due to the aging population and rising prevalence of chronic diseases. Despite the rise, there's also been an increase in the number of such cardiac arrest patients who receive CPR from bystanders. It jumped from 22% in 2011 to 62% in 2018. Cancer survivor Grace Young is one of those who benefited. She had went into cardiac arrest 5 times and managed to receive CPR every single time.
It is very, very important. I encourage everybody to learn. You may not know who is the next one that needs the help. You need to save them. You have to follow. You know what to do. Rather than just depend on the call, calling the ambulance.
And Dr. C, CPR is a vital step towards patients benefiting from hospital care.
There are a lot of new therapies that are currently available or that we are working on at the hospital anyway. But the person will only have a chance to receive all these new advanced treatments if they actually get early CPR and early defibrillation. So we can have further improvements in terms of bystander CPR, more people can help as volunteer first responders.
To this end, SHF will work together with the Institute of Technical Education to offer more CPR training opportunities to the community.